Hi everyone, today I will be teaching about how to use VoiceStream Reader. I'm using an iPad, so you'll want to begin by downloading and opening the VoiceStream Reader app icon. The icon is navy blue with an open book image. Let's start on the VoiceStream Reader homepage. This page includes all items ever put into VoiceStream, but you will want to organize your readings. To do that, select the down arrow to the left of all items at the top middle of the screen. Select by folder and choose the plus sign to create a new folder for your book title, class, etc. And select OK. You can move a reading from all items page to a creative folder by holding down on a reading and selecting the folder icon, which then gives you the option of where to move it. To begin reading, select an item from your library or folder. I've selected a PDF article that was scanned by our office and made readable. Before beginning to read, let's take some time to review the features within the reading page. In the top left-hand corner, there is a house icon, a dog-eared sheet of paper icon, and a double slider icon. The house icon will bring you to the All Items homepage listing all your materials. The sheet of paper icon is where you have options to export or print. Exporting is really cool because all your highlights can be saved to another document. You have the option to AirDrop, add to notes, or add to any other app you might have on your device. The double slider icon is the controls where reading mode, timer, and further settings can be changed. The top right-hand corner is what we think is most important to successful usage of VoiceStream Reader. The first icon is a circle with radiating lines. This is where audio settings can be adjusted. You can increase or decrease the speech rate, change the spoken language, and personalize the voice of the speaker. The speaker listed here should be the one you chose for free when you downloaded the app. The next icon is a capitalized letter A and a lowercase letter A for visual settings. In this feature, you can change the text to plain or original layout. The color of the screen can be adjusted as well to light, dark, custom, or original. We are using original. The color settings option allows for the highlight, spoken word, and line colors to be changed. In this demo, we are using a yellow highlight and a dark blue color for both the spoken word and line. By selecting on highlight, spoken word, or spoken line, you are able to select from a variety of colors that can guide your reading. The next icon is a shaded in bookmark. By selecting this icon, a bookmark is created at whatever location you are in the text. I was at the start of the article, so now a bookmark is at the author's name.